says,
yes, sir.
I see men, but they look like trees.
Come on.
And all the thing that I know they ain't trees because they walk.
All right.
Okay.
Come on now.
What he's really communicating is, watch this.
Yes, sir.
I'm thankful that I'm seeing an improvement.
All right.
Yeah.
But really, that ain't enough.
All right. All right.
All right. He says, I'm thankful for the improvement because I am seeing better than I was. He said, but really, Jesus, I need some more.
Yeah.
Can I get 30 of y'all to just holler, I need some more? Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Listen. Listen to me, ladies and gentlemen. Don't you ever make the mistake of confusing ambition with the lack of appreciation.
Come on.
Listen. Here's what I mean. I'm thankful for what he's already done.
Yeah.
But I still want some more. Y'all not gonna talk. That's because y'all been singing that song that church folks sing. And y'all been singing that saying that church folks say that if God don't do another thing, he's already done enough. Now Mama Jackie, that sounds good. But for 99% of us, that's a lie. You do know you can sing a lie just as well as you can tell one. Y'all not talking. And let's just keep this real. I don't care how much God bless you in the past. If he stopped blessing you now, you're going to be in trouble. I don't care how many times he made a way for you yesterday. If you live in the day, you're going to need another way. I don't care what he's done today. If you get up in the morning, you're going to need some more. That's why I don't never tell God, if you don't never do nothing else, you done all. God, I thank you for what you already done, but I still need some more. Can I get 35 of y'all in this room? Jack is saying, I need some more. Come on. Just touch your neighbor and tell them, I need some more. No, that's the wrong neighbor. Because that neighbor, they don't need what you need. But find somebody and touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I need some more. I'm gone now. But you know what happened? When I read the text and the man said, I need some more. Chills, he didn't get offended. Chills, he didn't scold the man. Chills, he didn't tell the man, you want to be thankful for what you have. All Jesus did was touch the man one more time. Can I get a witness? Is there anybody here that can testify that I need another touch? Can I get a witness? I'm going now, y'all. But you know, the Bible says that you have not because you ask not. Ask and it shall be given. You got to tell God, I thank you for what you done. But the truth is, I need some more. Can I get a witness? Can I get a witness? I need a little more power, a little more grace, a little more mercy, a little more favor, a little more blessing. Is there anybody here that need a little more joy? Shall I get a witness? You all open your mouth and tell God, I need some more. I think I better tell you before I leave you now. But really, you want to ask some more. I think I better tell you that he ain't enough. Shall I get a witness? He is able. I heard it in a minute. That he is able to do what he said he would do. And when you ask God, you got to know that he is able. Will anybody in the room, I feel like preaching now. Will anybody in the room tonight that know he is able? If you don't mind, do me one favor. Touch your neighbor. Ain't got to shake your hand, but just touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I tried and he the man asked for some more. Because he knew he was dealing with somebody who had more to give. I can give you what I got. And once I've given you all I got, don't ask me for no more.
Talk. Yes,
sir.
Because I ain't got it.
All right.
You short on money?
Uh-huh.
I give you $100.
Yeah.
Don't ask me for no more.
All right.
That's it.
Because
I'm a limited resource.
Come on.
But you don't go to God like you come to me.
Come on.
Where I'm limited, he's unlimited.
Yeah.
And if $100 ain't enough when you ask God, don't be ashamed.
Yeah.
Ask him for a little more. He got so much. The Bible says he got so much he got tired of counting the calories.
Alright.
And start counting the years.
That's right.
He said, count on 1,000 years.
Yes, sir.
In other words, I got too much to count.
That's right.
So when you need something, don't be ashamed. Don't be shy. Don't be bashful. Do just like that man. He said, I thank you for what you did. But the truth is, that ain't enough. I need some more. If you can believe it, before the year's over, God says, I'm going to give you some more. I know the first touch really didn't do what you needed to do. God said, I was just seeing if you would acknowledge what you can see and trust me for what you can't see. Don't act like I didn't do nothing for you. I know it's just a little bit, but still tell me thank you for the little bit before you ask me. Problem is, some of us ain't got no more because we're not appreciative for the little. But the Bible says, if you're faithful over a few things, I'll make you ruler over men. I tell you this week, just 7 days, 365 days in a year, just 7 days out of 365, just 7 days, just go to God this week and just thank him for the little stuff. You know, like when you walk in the house and flip the switch and lights come on. You don't think that's a blessing because your lights ain't never been cut off. But if you ever had to have a candlelight dinner not trying to be romantic, if you ever had to sit at a table and have a candlelight dinner with your woman and you weren't trying to be romantic, you just out of the power cut the lights off. And ain't no feeling, Robin, ain't no feeling like when you finally get the money to pay it, and you run the house and flip that switch. And no feeling like going to brush your teeth in the morning.
Come on.
And turn the faucet.
Come on.
I'm busy. And ain't no water. That's a bad feeling. Been there. Well, it ain't shame because once God bring you out, you ain't ashamed to tell what you believe. See, I've been there where I had to go to the next door's house in the backyard and turn their faucet on. Took a big boiler, fill it up with water, go sit that pot on the stove. Let me tell you how to do it. When you want to get cut off, go to somebody else's house, get a jug, get some water, put the water on the stove and turn it on. You can't take no tub bath, but you take a sink bath. Pull that. Come on, pull it. flipping the switch and hanging up until there ain't nobody's home. But if you just thank God for the little stuff, like when the gas light come on, I'm riding the other day, I'm riding the other day down the road, and I just happened to look down, and my gas light was on. I said, God, all I did is pray to make it to the next. Got out, filled my car up, tried to get it, kept going. When I thought about it, there was a time. Was going low. And I wasn't praying to get to the next exit. God just let me get to the house. Ain't got no money to fill it up, but so now when I fill it up, I know, give me 5 more pump 10. Come on, man. Ain't no more. Put $10 worth to make it to. No, just go fill it up. Little stuff like that.